Good morning. So my name is Mrs. Fanning, and for those of you that don't know, this is the orchestra comprised of mostly 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. We're going to play Jingle Bell Rock. And then I have an amazing young lady that plays the cello. She's in the 6th grade. She sounds like, I mean, she's just amazing. She's going to play a solo. Then our last selection.
Mm-hmm. good morning, DESA family. My name is Dr. Morris, band director here. And here's your band, not mine, your band. And they will be performing one of the selections right now called Jingle Balls. Not Jingle Bells, but Jingle what? Alright, Jingle Balls.
Number one, what we would like for you to do is sit on your bottoms. Let's reposition ourselves. Sit on your bottoms. If you can hear me, clap once, clap twice. Now we're moving to dance. You're actually gonna see. All right. If you can hear me, clap once, twice. Three times. You'll see candy canes twice. So you're not seeing double. You really are seeing double. So candy canes part one. Candy canes part one. fourth and fifth grade vocals. Give it up for dance. Fourth and fifth grade vocals. Fourth and fifth grade vocals. Fourth and fifth grade vocals, take your positions. Fourth and fifth grade vocals, take your position. Fourth and fifth grade vocals. Give it up for fourth and fifth grade. Take your bow. Transition over here. Go to your open space. Fourth and fifth grade, transition in the space that's there for you. Fourth and fifth grade, transition in the space that's there for you. Fourth and fifth grade, transition to the space over here for you. Fourth and fifth grade, transition to the open space. Fourth and fifth grade, transition to the open space. Thank you. Sixth grade, take your spot. Sixth grade, take your spot. Sit in the red right here, then sit down in the red. Just have a seat in the red then. There you go. If you can hear me clap once, twice, you're seated on your bottom. Crisscross applesauce. Ladies and gentlemen, your sixth grade vocals. Students, before they begin Snow, Snow, Snow. Before they begin Snow, Snow, Snow. Your voices are off and should remain off while they're singing. Thank you. Sixth grade. Sixth grade, you can go that way. Sixth grade, go that way. And there's an open space for you between 7 and 8. Sixth grade, go that way. Miss Jeter, we're going to cut to the children's scene and then bring 7, 8. We're going to cut to the children's dance, the party scene, and then cut to 7, 8. Next up, we have, from Nutcracker in a Nutshell, we have the party scene with your 4th and 5th graders. Bring it to you, 7th grade vocals! Put your stuff in it. 7th grade vocals! If you can hear me clap once, if you can hear me clap twice, if you can hear me clap 3 times, we are seated on our bottoms. Audience etiquette, we don't scream. We can clap and say bravo, but we don't scream. So please give your attention. We're headed to our last couple of pieces. So we're our last vocal piece will be from our 7th and 8th grade vocal students. Okay? Our last vocal piece. Quiet, because this piece is without music accompaniment. Their voices are the music. Give it up for your 7th and 8th grade vocal students. Go that way. Go that way to your open spot. Go that way. Go that way. Thank you. And now, you're not seeing doubles. Our last set of candy canes. You're not seeing double. Our last set of candy canes.
Thank you.
style, and then we're going to hold kindergarten. My fellas are going to help us get our tables down. Kindergarten will stay in here. Kindergarten and first grade stay in here so we can get you lunch. We'll get your tables down. But you all kind of like this kind of stuff that the band does. So they're going to give you a little some. Miss Mahone said she missed it. So I wanted to make sure she got it. Mahone, this is what you told me you missed. I wanted to make sure you got it. I want to keep my word, Miss Mahone. Give you a little some, and that you said we missed it, and then we'll do Lego League. I didn't forget. This year's team went to compete. They're gonna give you a little bit of what they did for the win. Give it up for the Lego League. You gonna need, I know this one. They might have to project. All right, come on up. This is, use the stage extension as your place. Mr. Linhart, I think we might only be able to use one. Let's see. Miss Jones, Miss Malky. All right. It starts with you. It starts with you, right? All right. If you can please give them your full attention. If you can hear me, clap once. Clap twice. You can bring it up, team. Bring it up a little bit closer. You can use the stage extension, bring it up a little bit closer. You don't have to come on up a little, come on to the stage extension. Come on up a little bit closer. Make sure your TV is in place. All right. You're gonna have to project and we'll pass you the mic, okay? All right.
Good morning. We are the Lego Legacy team and we're so happy to be here.
What happened to all the lights? Why is it so dark in here? Is this what happens when we use too much non-renewable energy? No more hot water, no more electricity, no more non-renewable energy?
Hey, get off, that shower water's been running for a little bit too long. Get off of TikTok and get in the shower. We're leaving in 30 minutes. If I can get in the shower.
Good morning, Atlanta. The time now is 6:15.
believe I left the TV on all night. Let me turn the volume up. Here in Atlanta, the weather is hot and sunny with a 0% chance of rain.
Would you like to help retain non-renewable energy and prevent possible blackouts in our future? Well, the LEGO Legacy Energy Tracker app is here to help with the expertise of the LEGO Legacy engineers. The problem we picked is that we use too much non-renewable energy. To solve this, we had to ask ourselves, why is it so hard to stop using non-renewable energy? Now let's take a look at our app.
As you can see on our home screen, we have our logo that represents our app, which is LEGO Legacy Energy Tracker, which can also stand for LLET. We decided to go with a tree because it represents the environment. And we decided to go with lightning bolts because it represents energy, and we want people to know that we're saving energy to help the environment. As you can see, we have a drop-down menu which tells you what the different screens is about. First, we have our home screen, and then our about our app, our benefits, and our notifications. Here, if you click about our app, you can find in our app, we want to track your energy uses so that you can be aware of how much energy you use. You can set goals, and the more energy you use, your bills can also get really high, and we know you don't want to spend more. Our goal is so we can have a clean and safe planet, reducing the amount of non-renewable energy we use.
The benefits of our app are you save more money on your energy bill, you save the environment, you'll have a better world for your children, you can reduce highly toxic poisons, and you'll have energy for the future.
When you click the drop-down menu and go to the notification page, you'll see this. You can set your notifications to notify you when you've used 50% of your monthly energy, 80%, or 100%. You enter your number below to get the notifications. You go to the you can set a default setting, which is 886 kilowatt hours. You can set a custom goal by using this down below, and you can see your current average household usage by going on your electricity bill.
Their own regional competition with the app that they created, with the script that they wrote, with support from our drama teachers. Congratulations, and give it up for your LEGO League. Give it up for each other. All right, DESA, there's one last thing I want you to do. If I can have everyone's attention, you can hear me clap once. Clap twice, clap three times. Students do come first, and you're the reason why we work. But without these people, there is no school. So please give it up for your amazing teachers. Give it all, scream, holler, stand an ovation.